Irma?
Yep.
Nothing?
No, I didn't.
Please you tell the family.
I didn't do nothing to shoot this guy. I didn't do anything to kill this guy. I did nothing. This guy chased us. I did nothing to kill this guy. It's crazy.
So they chased you.
Well, good afternoon. Thank you all so much for joining us. This is a follow-up to a case that you all, many of the media outlets came to last week. So this is just a continuing, the kind of the next episode in that case. That suspect that y'all just met was John Yates. Last name spelled Y-E-A-T-E-S. 10-12 of 84 is his date of birth. And he's being booked for deadly conduct, third-degree felony deadly conduct. As you may recall, on September 11th, we received a call to the 15,200 block of US 181 for a report of a crash. That crash happened in the aftermath of a dumping incident that turned into a high-speed pursuit between two civilian vehicles with shots exchanged, and then ended with that crash where we found the victim in this case, George Gomez, 36 years of age, deceased. At that point, we didn't know how it was that Gomez had passed. We have since come to learn the cause and manner of death. But it's reported that John Yates was actually a passenger in an orange Dodge pickup that was involved in that case that day. You all may recall that in the aftermath of the crash, we had put out information on an orange Dodge truck. Later on that afternoon, one of our patrol sergeants that was just on routine patrol found the Dodge truck on the side of the flat tire, knew that there'd been an exchange of gunfire, and so decided to stop and check it out. And as it appears, during the course of that exchange of gunfire, this truck actually got sustained a flat tire, and that's why it was on the side of the road where it was. On that day, some people that were in the truck were questioned. It was determined that John Yates did have some involvement. What we're able to gather to this point is that Yates and another suspect had stopped in the Laguna Road to dump some trash on a property. Some people that are employees of the property owners decided to stop and confront that pickup truck as they were dumping. My understanding is it was leaves and you know, yard landscaping type matter that they were dumping. They were confronted. During the course of that confrontation, weapons were displayed by one or both parties. The orange truck fled the scene at a high rate of speed, and my understanding is those employees of that property did also follow and begin a pursuit. At a certain point, 911 was called by some of the folks in one of the witness vehicles, and you know, at a certain point, my understanding is that one of the vehicles dropped off, but the other continued to follow, the vehicle of the man that eventually crashed. During the course of this pursuit, you can see it's a long pursuit covering several miles. We did receive several calls for shots fired of a small gray car and an orange truck firing shots at each other. You can see we're on Highway 87 East near China Grove. That's where we received a call for shots fired. The suspect vehicle and the complainant vehicle parted ways a short distance up close to the Independent School District offices. Eventually, we believe that the victim in the case, Mr. Gomez, decided to head back toward the place of business when he was involved in that fatal crash in the 15,200 block of US 181. It should be noted that the initial call for service for the dumping was at the 12,700 block of US 181. It appears by all accounts that Mr. Gomez was heading back to the place of business when he lost control of the vehicle for whatever reason, left the roadway, and pretty much buried himself into some trees that were there and sustained some injuries. We've since come to find out that it appears that Mr. Gomez suffered a broken neck, broken back, and possibly a heart attack. So we're not positive at this point whether the heart attack was as a result of the injuries sustained, or possibly may have been that due to the excitement of this whole incident, he suffered that medical episode, which led to him losing control of the vehicle. Either way, At this point, that day we were able to determine that Mr. Yates was involved. Since that time, our fugitive apprehension unit has been looking for Yates. Our homicide unit has been working this case up. We were able to find him earlier today, and he was taken into custody at his residence without incident. He was brought in and he was questioned, along with the other person that we believe was in the car on the day of the dumping shooting crash. It appears that Yates was armed with a handgun during the course of that dumping and pursuit incident. There was an exchange of gunfire. The information that we have is that the man in the car, Gomez, was firing a weapon at them. He was indeed found with a weapon, and it was a Draco, kind of a small knockoff AK-47 type weapon that Gomez had in the car with him. On the day that we took custody of this orange truck, a 380 pistol was found in there, and we believe that 380 pistol is the gun that was brandished by Yates during the course of this incident. Again, we do have information that Yates did indeed fire back at Mr. Gomez, but we do not believe that he was struck, and we don't believe that his car was even struck at this point, but we do believe that there was a mutual exchange of gunfire between the two. At this point, he is going to be facing charges for the deadly conduct, for at least the firing of the shots, but at this point, again, we don't have any indicator that Mr. Gomez suffered any gunshot wounds, that he suffered any gunshot wounds. Esta tarde nosotros arrestamos a John Yates, este hombre, este sospechoso que se enfrenta con cargos por sus acciones en ese día, donde ustedes ya pueden recordar que ese día, el día 11 de septiembre, nosotros recibimos una llamada por un choque, donde un hombre de 36 años de edad, George Gomez, falleció en ese choque. Eso pasó en la carretera 181. Se aparenta que este hombre y otro sospechoso, John Yates, ellos fueron a un negocio en 181 y cerca de Laguna Road a tirar basura en esa propiedad. Ya dos empleados de ese negocio se enfrentaron con los sospechosos. Se aparenta que alguien empezó a enseñar armas durante ese argumento. El sospechoso y los dos sospechosos huyeron de la escena en una camioneta anaranjada, marca Dodge. Los dos empleados del negocio empezaron a perseguir esa camioneta y en algunos momentos durante ese, donde iban persiguiendo los sospechosos, ellos empezaron a disparar hacia uno al otro. Ya nosotros recibimos varias llamadas que estaban teniendo un tiroteo, sabemos que en 87 el sospechoso, el vehículo del sospechoso, lograron perder la otra víctima, pero se aparenta que la víctima, George Gomez, empezó a regresar al negocio cuando él tuvo ese choque. Ahora, aunque pensamos ahorita que ellos sí intercambiaron balazos, pensamos que nadie fue herido, sino que Gómez falleció en el choque. Ahora, por la causa de la autopsia, sí sabemos que él se quebró el pescuezo, se quebró la espalda y sufrió un ataque de corazón. Pero no se sabe si el ataque de corazón fue a causa del choque o fue la causa del choque. De cualquier manera, ese día después del choque, cuando nosotros dimos el reporte a la prensa, uno de nuestros oficiales, sargento de patrulla, se encontró con la camioneta, la encontró, tenía agujerada una llanta a causa de un balazo. Nosotros en ese día no logramos arrestar al John Yates, sino que ese día nosotros llegamos con la información que él estaba involucrado. Ahora, se sabe que nosotros ya conocemos a Yates de otros incidentes que hemos tenido con él y lo hemos estado buscando desde ese día. Nosotros este día lo arrestamos y ahora se enfrenta con cargos por deadly conduct. Any questions?
I have a question.
Sure.
Is there any evidence that Gomez fired first, or do you know who fired first?
Well, at this point, we believe that it's possible Gomez may have fired first.
And I'm looking at the bullet holes. Did y'all find those as well on this car?
Oh, absolutely. So it looks like from what we're hearing from this side, from the folks that were in this truck, that Gomez was firing through his own windshield while pursuing them. And the evidence that we found on Gomez's car is consistent with that. Now, whether or not they shot back at Gomez is a distinct possibility. Look, I'm going to be honest. Had Mr. Gomez survived this crash, he may very well be facing charges as well. And it's really all for the foolishness of it all. It's really all due to illegal dumping, which absolutely is a crime. Absolutely needs to be taken seriously. But I don't know that confronting somebody with deadly force is necessarily the answer with regard to that. Yes, we all have the right to defend ourselves and our property, but again, taking the law into your own hands, chasing somebody down and firing shots at them, certainly not the recommended course of conduct in a case like this.
Sheriff, la camioneta estuvo, veo una foto de donde estaban tirando que esta camioneta es lo que estaban tirando ahí arriba.
Sí.
Recuerdo cuando estuviste ahí con nosotros en la carretera, no se sabía mucho, este todavía estaba jugado. ¿Cómo fue que lo aprendieron? Tal vez hoy, pero ¿cómo fue que llegaron al arresto de él?
Uno de nuestros oficiales, un sargento, iba en patrulla y él se encontró con esta camioneta. Él sabía que estábamos buscando la camioneta. Él estaba en la escena del choque. Ya cuando iba en patrulla después del choque, él vio esta camioneta, sabíamos que estábamos buscando una camioneta.
¿La había abandonado?
No, habían dos sospechosos, estaban con testigos, más bien testigos, estaban con la camioneta. Se aparenta que Yates y otros sospechosos se fueron, le dejaron esta camioneta con la llanta agujerada y ellos fueron a tratar de conseguir otra llanta. Ya cuando ellos regresaron para cambiar la llanta, vieron que nosotros teníamos varios carros de patrulla con esta camioneta y ya de ahí ellos huyeron y nunca regresaron. Pero ya para ese tiempo nosotros habíamos conseguido la información que Yates estaba involucrado. Es conocido para nosotros, ya hemos tenido varios incidentes donde lo hemos arrestado. Más recientemente, me parece que en agosto lo arrestamos a él por drogas y por una llamada donde nosotros estamos buscando una mujer y una bebita de 9 meses de edad. Las encontramos a las dos. Ella, la mamá de la bebita, es novia de Yates. Y entre ellos dos se enfrentaron con cargos de child endangerment ese día por tener drogas y armas cerca de la bebita. Entonces ya sabemos de él. También nosotros cuando estamos hablando ahí arriba, uno de nuestros oficiales del FAU que arrestaron a Yates este día, antes ese oficial estaba con la unidad de narcotics y él recuerda donde ellos lo arrestaron hace varios años. Entonces ya es alguien que tiene varios, tiene historia criminal y es el más reciente arresto.
¿Puso resistencia al arresto?
No, este día afortunadamente no puso resistencia. Él fue arrestado sin incidente, pero ahora a ver cómo le va. Sure. So what we know about Yates is we do have a history with him. He's got a lengthy criminal history, burglary of a building, abandoning, endangering a child. In August, as a matter of fact, we were in the process of looking for a missing young lady and her 9-month-old baby. Now, the young lady, the mother of the baby, is Yates' girlfriend. So she was found at his property, safe and sound. However, there was drugs found, and there was a high-capacity assault-type weapon found, and so very close to the baby. And so Yates and the mother on that day, they were faced with charges. They still face charges. I believe they're out on bond for that, for abandoning, endangering a child, endangering a child and possession of controlled substance. For placing the baby in that situation. Additionally, one of the FAU deputies that arrested Yates today without incident actually recognized him from prior. That deputy used to be with the narcotics unit and remembers having arrested him for a narcotic case several years ago. So this suspect here is no stranger to law enforcement.
You mentioned
back to fix the tire, right?
Oh, yes, that part, yes. So we found that when the patrol sergeant found the vehicle on the side of 1604, there were two people with it. Those people are considered to be witnesses at this point, not suspects. But what we were able to determine that day is that Yates and the other suspect who were in the car when the car sustained the bullet hole to the tire, left the scene that day to go try to get a replacement tire. When they came back with the tire, they saw that patrol had already detained the people that were there with the truck, and they decided to just continue on and not stop because they figured they were going to be facing some criminal charges. Yates also intimated to us during the interview that he knew that the person that had been chasing them and firing shots at each other that had died in the crash, and he was afraid he was going to get blamed for that somehow. So he decided to flee. So this whole time, he's known that the law enforcement was looking for him.
You mentioned...
No, por ahorita ya sabemos quiénes son los otros testigos en el caso. Ahorita, pues, es posible que alguien más se vaya a enfrentar con cargos, pero por ahorita Yates es el único que nosotros tenemos cargos. Ahora, si nos llega más información, es posible que alguien más vaya a enfrentarse con cargos.
You mentioned a second suspect. Has that person facing charges? Have you arrested them?
Well, he's a suspect in the illegal dumping at this point. We don't have any evidence that that man fired any shots. That other man was the driver of the orange truck on that day. So we have been talking here that it's possible we may be filing a charge of illegal dumping on them both. So it's possible Yates may face another charge. It's a Class B misdemeanor. But again, it is possible that we may be looking for that driver whom we already know. We interviewed him earlier today, and he was cooperative. But it is possible they may face additional charges for the illegal dumping that kicked this whole thing off. Bueno, ese hombre desafortunadamente falleció a causa de lo que pasó, su crisis médica que él tuvo. Pero también sé yo que si hubiera sobrevivido el choque, es posible que él también se hubiera enfrentado con cargos por andar disparando una arma en una carretera con tráfico y con todo. Pero desafortunadamente el hombre falleció.
Just to confirm, Mr. Gomez was not hit with gunfire.
Mr. Gomez was not hit by gunfire. Initially, on that day, there was a wound that we found on his side. But then we came to find out that was due to a chest tube that was put in by EMS. So it was a pretty decent sized hole, and it looks like it could have been a gunshot, but it appears to have been medical intervention that was taking place.
Cuando habla del accidente, y eso a lo mejor yo lo tuve muy claro ese día que estuvimos ahí, ¿hubo entonces algún otro conductor involucrado en ese accidente o él nomás perdió control?
No, ellos, can you go back to the map? Ellos ya no se vieron después de este punto. Ellos se separaron. Me parece que el sospechoso, la camioneta siguió en el 1604 y la víctima, el Gómez, él empezó a ir para atrás para el negocio y él tuvo ese choque aquí. No pensamos que había otro carro involucrado, sino que es posible que él tuvo ese ataque de corazón causando el choque, o es posible que él sufrió ese ataque después del choque.
Pero cuando hablas de un choque, ¿hubo otro involucrado o es que él se salió sin...
Él se salió del camino y se estrelló con unos árboles y ahí quedó el carro, pero no pensamos que otro carro estaba involucrado. ¿Any other questions? Okay, thank you all so much for joining us.
Thank you.